Hello, in this video I am going to talk about the problem of achalasia cardia, the basic understanding about this disease, the problems faced by these patients and about the tests and investigations needed to diagnose this disease. Achalasia cardia is a rare swallowing disorder which makes it difficult for the food, both solid and liquid, to pass down your food pipe into your stomach. It is commonly seen in the age group of 25 to 60 years, but rarely it is seen in children also. In achalasia cardia, the nerve cells in the wall of your food pipe, that is the esophagus, degenerate for reasons which are not known. Food pipe or esophagus is a tube that passes your food from your mouth to the stomach. To understand what happens in achalasia cardia, let's first understand the normal process of swallowing. When a normal person swallows, the food passes down the food pipe into the stomach by the rhythmic contractions of the muscles of the food pipe. These contractions are called peristalsis. Also, as the food passes from the esophagus to the stomach, the LES valve or the lower esophageal valve located at the lower end of the food pipe relaxes and opens to allow the food to pass to the stomach. Once the food passes to the stomach, the LES valve closes tightly. Thus, it prevents the food and the acid in the stomach to flow back or reflux back into the esophagus. The reflux of acid causes damage to the lower part of the food pipe, causing ulcers and heartburn. Thus, the proper functioning of this LES valve is very important. In patients with achalasia, the loss of nerve cells in the food pipe, that is the esophagus, causes two major problems that interferes with the swallowing of food. First, the muscles of the food pipe, that is the esophagus, do not contract properly. Hence, the food is not propelled from the esophagus to the stomach in a normal manner. Secondly, the LES valve, that is the lower esophageal sphincter, do not relax common swallowing. This creates a barrier which prevents food and liquid from passing to the stomach in a normal manner. Over a period of time, the part of the food pipe above the LES valve dilates, that is, it becomes enlarged and distended, and large amount of food and saliva are collected in this enlarged or dilated food pipe. The most common symptom of achalasia cardia is difficulty in swallowing. Patients get the sensation of food getting stuck in the chest. This happens with both solid and liquid food. Because of this, they may feel chest pain while eating. The food that is stuck in the food pipe, in the chest part, flows back and comes to the throat or mouth when they lie down. Occasionally, there is cough and water coming out from the nose while sleeping. The food that remains in the food pipe causes ulceration in the food pipe and leads to heartburn. Weight loss is also seen in most of the patients of achalasia cardia. This problem often begins slowly and progresses gradually. Many of the patients do not seek help till the symptoms are advanced. Some patients try to compensate by eating slowly and by maneuvers like lifting the neck or throwing back the shoulders to help emptying of the food pipe. Achalasia cardia also increases the chances of developing cancer of the food pipe, and hence timely treatment and a good follow-up are very, very important. Achalasia cardia can be overlooked or misdiagnosed because its symptoms many a times overlap with lot many other digestive disorders. The initial test for any patients who complain of problems with swallowing are an endoscopy and a diet test. Upper GI endoscopy. In this test, your doctor will pass a thin, flexible tube equipped with a light and a camera down your throat to examine your food pipe and your stomach. In achalasia cardia patients, food residue is very commonly seen on endoscopy. Also, the lower esophageal sphincter, the LES valve, do not open up easily as would happen in a normal patient. The main purpose of doing an endoscopy is to rule out the other diseases that presents as difficulty in swallowing, like tumors, strictures or narrowings, severe ulcerations, and a foreign body. Barium swallow or a diet test. X-rays are taken after you swallow a chalky white liquid called barium or a thin watery dye that fills and coats the inner part of your food pipe and your stomach. A radiologist can see the passage of dye from your food pipe to your stomach on an X-ray machine. In a person with achalasia cardia, the X-rays will show the holdup of the dye in the esophagus, the dilatation of the esophagus, that is your food pipe, and the narrowing at the lower end of the food pipe, suggesting non-relaxation or non-opening of the LES valve. Although quite accurate, in some patients in the initial stages of achalasia, these findings may not be present when the esophagus has not much dilated. Esophageal manometry. Manometry is the final confirmatory test and is a must for the diagnosis for achalasia cardia. Manometry measures the rhythmic contractions of the muscle of your food pipe when you swallow food, the coordination and the force exerted by the food pipe muscles while swallowing. It also measures how well the LES valve relaxes on swallowing. In the early phases of achalasia cardia, when the X-ray, that is the barium study, and endoscopy may be normal, manometry is the only test which can diagnose the patients with achalasia cardia. It also differentiates among the different types of achalasia cardia. The outcomes of various types of treatment of achalasia depend upon these definition of the types of achalasia cardia. Thus, manometry helps in predicting the outcome and deciding the treatment of achalasia cardia. Hope this video has helped you understand your problem. You can also watch our other videos giving the details about the treatment options of achalasia cardia and also about the esophageal manometry test. For any further queries or clarifications, you can call us or send your reports on WhatsApp or email us.